stop, shin height. Squeeze your booty up to the top. Remember, knees stay slightly bent, but you're pushing your butt down and back behind you. You feel the stretch in the hamstring, and then you're squeezing your butt right there as you come up to the top. We've got a great view behind us, so we want to make the view behind you just as nice. Working the posterior right here. Remember to keep your back flat. We're looking right down, a few feet in front of us, straight down. We're not in any hurry. We're not going for a certain amount of reps. We're just going to continue to move through 50 seconds. Perfect. Core stays in nice and tight. No arching the back. Got it in 3, 2, 1. Bend your knees, set it down. I'm going to go with my medium weight. Actually, my lighter weight is a 30-pound dumbbell. That's what I'm going to go into. Now, take the weight up. Set it against your shoulders. You're stepping front lunge with the weighted twist. Remember to keep your feet hip distance apart. In 3, 2, 1. Step forward, twist, and step back. Remember, as we go through this movement, it's all about perfect form. Every movement's about perfect form, but especially this one, as we talk about balance. You always have your feet hip distance apart. As you step forward, you have your balance by not going too narrow. You feel like you're moving side to side. Probably means you're too narrow. So bring your feet a little bit wider, and as you lunge forward, you stop right before your knee touches the ground. Perfect. Stay with it. Sit down, twist, keep your chest lifted. Nice. Keep the weight just set right up against your shoulders. You got this. Stay with it. Feel a little heat in the legs. 3, 2, 1. Nicely done. Set it down. Shake out the legs. In 3, 2, 1. Sit down. Back up. Now, with the weight, it's a little bit different. We went into a front-loaded movement. What's this mean on your front-loaded movement? Your feet should be right up underneath your hips. Bring your feet a little bit more. A little more. There we go. Perfect. And what we do is in a front-loaded movement, a lot of times, you see the weight trying to drag you forward. What we're doing here is not only are we working the legs, we're working core control and stability. So you see Deja and the rest of the team, everyone has their chest lifted, and that allows you to sit straight down, put knees to stay behind your toes, push through your heels, straight up to the top, and it's all about control. Wonderful job. Let me get a couple of two. You guys don't have to have all the fun. Straight down, straight back up. You got this. 3, 2, 1. Set it down. You have the choice. You can stick with the same weight. If you want to go heavier weight more, you can go a little bit lighter. I'm going with the heavy weight. Take your feet out nice and wide. Toes towards us. Weight is sinking down. Pick it up. We're going 3, 2, 1. To the side and to the side. Now, we already talked about this last week, but I want you to think about your movement pattern first. Is to sink down. Keep your chest lifted the entire time, all right? So that's why I have no weight right now, to really show you that the chest should stay lifted and you're sinking down and back. This is really the point of the movement pattern right here. To sit down, really isolate the glutes, the hamstrings, the quads. Everything's feeling, you're feeling it everywhere, especially inside, inner thighs, and the glutes. Perhaps a little bit. Sink it down. Deja, what weight do you have right there?
15.
Do you feel it?
I feel it.
Good. It's all about, we're going time and attention right here. You got this. Come on. Stay strong. 3, 2, 1.